I'm in the headquarters of the Indian Space Research Organization, and I have with me Professor U.R. Rao, well-known Indian space scientist, and the man who decided what would be the scientific experiments and the rationale for the Indian mission to Mars. Professor Rao, why should India go to Mars?
Well, one of the important things is that we must understand the planetary in the atmosphere's planetary evolution, and so that we understand our own Earth better, how it started and the various phenomena which we have. And this is the scientific, the quest for this. The other thing is that there are possibilities that we will have to depend upon resources, because our own resources on the Earth are going to vanish or within the next maybe 200 to 300 years. The oil, for example, can't even last 200 years, but even coal and even steel, we have a problem. Therefore, we'll have to find resources from elsewhere, and one of the possibilities is whether we can get this from other planets, particularly Moon and Mars.
So is Earth, Moon and Mars one large industrial complex in your opinion?
It could become, because see, the particularly Mars, in fact, we think that maybe another 500 years or 1,000 years, we may be able to colonize Mars and even have human population there. Because it is, in many respects, it is possible we know how to do it. And the question, of course, is when we'll start doing it. One of the major things is we have to bring down the cost of transportation, space transportation, which is already down from what it was earlier, but even this will go down with the newer technologies coming in. And there are many ways of doing it, and everybody is trying to do this, including a possibility of having a space elevator. And this was what Arthur Clarke talked about 25 years ago, and we think it is possible, of course, if we can use the nanotechnology, and surely put elevators to the geostationary orbit.
You were the key person who selected the instruments or the scientific part of the Indian Mars mission. Are you happy with the instruments which have been selected? Could they have been better?
First, I was the chairman of the committee, but the committee consisted of other people also who were scientists, in fact. Five, six scientists, we sat together, and detailed presentations from each of the proposer, and based on that we selected, and within the constraints of the weight and power limitations of the Mars mission. Now, with the experiments which we had, we selected the best we think we can, and also made some suggestions so that they are further improved.
All of the instruments come from ISRO. Does that make you feel unhappy that the universities are not party to it?
Yes and no. This time we had no choice because the universities are not capable of doing it right now. And since the time was very short and we have to have the launch by November of this year, the only place we could get these things were within the ISRO family. Therefore, it was restricted. Because otherwise, if we had larger amount, for example, any more Chandrayaan flights and so on, we will have probably proposals from elsewhere. But I do have the problem of actually, I'm very upset that the universities, even the best of the research institutions in the country, are not proposing the experiments. And one of the things I find is that the emphasis on experimentation is going down. Nobody wants to do this type of experiments. Yes, it is time consuming. And certainly, yes, sometimes there are possibilities it may not work or it may fail. But the entire science growth, particularly in space, every year since the space voyages started, we have been having great discoveries. They came from the instruments from the institutions like Iowa or MIT or Caltech or and so on. And why is it that experimenters are not making the proposals from the universities? And even when the proposals come, there seems to be a In fact, I believe that the emphasis on experiments is going away, and we will pay for it very badly. And the technology cannot be built unless these such experiments are made.
You mentioned that we need to launch this by October, November. Yeah. Now, is there a certain race between India and China? Are we competing with China?
No. This has nothing to do with China. This is something to do with the Mars and the competition between Mars and the Earth. Mars comes nearest, and therefore, even then, it'll take about nine and a half months. And therefore, the slot for going to Mars are fixed in that sense. Otherwise, you need far more energy, and that means we'll carry much lesser weight.
But do you think we will be able to beat China? Is there an issue there?
It is immaterial. There will be many more missions, I'm sure, because this is the time, nothing to do with India or anything. This is the time Mars comes nearest, and we'll have the quickest possible reach to Mars.
And how do we compare with China, America, and India as far as their capabilities go? Is China really competing with others?
China may be competing with us. Certainly, we are not competing with anybody. We are just doing it for our own development. And yes, China has certainly very strong rockets, and they have capabilities to launch even up to 9-10. We don't have yet. Our GSLV has to come, and then the GSLV has to be further upgraded. The America, of course, has no problem at all. They have China, if at all it's competing, it will compete with the USA, not with us. And anyway, it's immaterial. As far as we are concerned, within the constraints of our budget and within the constraints of our the technological development, we will have to do the best and see what best we can do.
And you think this was the best mission we could take, and this is the right time for the mission?
This is certainly the right time for the mission, and this is the best experiment within the weight capability of the PSLV. And if there was any other better experiment, we would have chosen it.
Some people suggest that, the founding father of the Indian space program, Vikram Sarabhai, said we should not have fantasy of going for planetary missions. Has ISRO moved away from that? Is that the right thing for ISRO to do? You have worked very closely with Dr. Vikram Sarabhai.
What Dr. Vikram told at that time was absolutely right. And without that, we would not have got the support which we got in the country. In fact, we programmed our entire pathway by essentially demonstrating the importance of satellites, whether it is for communication, whether it's for education, whether it's for meteorology, for the remote sensing and so on, and built around it. Now, having done that, now we have reached a point in the last, from 63 to today, to almost about 40, 45 years, we reached a point where we have actually, as far as the space, application of space to the societal thing is concerned, we certainly stand very tall in the world, and it is acknowledged all over the world. Now is the time we have to keep ourselves abreast of what is happening, start learning new technologies. Each technology, when you do something, it has its own feedback effect on the rest of the things. And we also have to develop scientific community. Otherwise, we will not have any new programs coming in. We can't go on doing the same thing over and over again. And again, these are the areas where it has maybe future, as certainly all of us, most of the scientists believe that we may have to depend both for energy as well as for resources, other planets, particularly Moon and the Mars. And the exploitation of planetary resources is one of the things uppermost in the mind of the people. For that, we have to bring down the cost of transportation. And that has effect in terms of ability to put larger payloads and so on. Therefore, time has come, and you can't develop a strong technological base unless you have programs of this type. Therefore, without spending too much money, we are trying to see what we can do, something which is important in science, at the same time produces great technologies.
Do you think if Professor Vikram Sarabhai were alive, would he have endorsed this mission in 2013?
I have no doubt about it. Don't forget that when we started the Physical Research Laboratory Ahmedabad, we all worked on the cosmic rays. That was not looking at the cosmic rays in the atmosphere. In fact, we were the only ones in the country at that time to use the cosmic rays to find out what is happening outside. Because these cosmic rays pass through the entire space from the distant stars, and in the pass through, they carry their information about the thing. Therefore, we are looking at the space, notwithstanding we are measuring on the ground. And this was one of the major things which, in fact, there are many groups of this type. We had Elliott's group in London, we had Simpson's group and they all were the first to get into the satellites. And Van Allen's, you name the major scientists, they were all in this type of thing. And of course, since we were looking at space even with the ground instrument, we were the first to get in. And this is the sort of a interaction between space and technology and science.
Are you happy with the way the mission is progressing today, the Mars mission for India?
It is progressing very well, and certainly yes, there are problems, but those problems are getting solved, and we had continuous to monitor these things, and we have reviews, and I'm sure that it'll go.
So that was Professor Yuvraj Rao telling us that if Dr. Vikram Sarabhai were alive, he would also have endorsed India's mission to Mars, even though he said planetary missions could be a fantasy for India. In the ISRO headquarters in Bangalore, Pallav Bagla for NDTV.